What's going on, traders and investors? Alex here, and in today's video, I'll show you how to create the Kristjan Kullamägi TC2000 scan, but in TradingView, because TradingView is better. So as usual, all the best tools for day trading will be linked down in the description. Don't forget, check that out. Let's get right in. So when it comes to finding the stock that he's looking for, they're normally going to be breakouts. So for example, a structure like this, and then we're going to look for a breakout in these type of play. We're also going to be looking for some stuff like we had in SMCI when it broke out of that big range over here, that 6 month or even, yeah, about 6-7 months range. This is what we're going to be looking for. So stock that made a big move higher, consolidate, and then breaks above an important level. And to do that, we're going to be using three scans. So we're going to use the 1 month, the 3 month, and then the 6 month. These are going to be done in the stock screener 2.0. To open it, the way you have to do this is just click on this plus button, and then you can go into screener and also click on this stock 2.0. It's going to bring you a screen like this over here, and then we're going to be customizing it to make sure it's top notch and giving you the best opportunity to grow your account as a swing trader. So when you're in this section, the first thing you're going to have to do is go into your screener over here, and then you're going to create a new scan. Or you can customize this one and then save it after. So a few things that are going to be important. If we start normally on the higher time frame, so it's going to be on the 6 month period or even 12 month. But generally speaking, 6 month is going to be the longest first scan that I'm looking for. And I think he does the same thing. And because I'm copying him, I'm going to do the same thing. So what's going to be important over here is to remove a few stuff, because there's just a lot of stuff that we don't need. And to do this, just, you know, click here, remove, watch this, we can't, but then price change, we can remove it. Market cap, we can leave it. PE, we can remove it. This one, we're going to remove it. Also this one, sector, remove it. Analyst rating, it's probably the most useless thing you're ever going to look at. So definitely remove this stuff. So performance, it's important to leave it. Revenue growth, we're going to remove it from here. PEG, remove this one, remove, and also this one, remove. By the way, at any point during this video, don't forget to check out the link in the description. I did link all the best tools for day trading and investing. So let's get back to the video. So this is what we're going to start with. So price, market cap, performances. We're going to need to add volume on this scan. After that, we're going to have volatility, because it's important to have stock that have a good range. So volatility, performance, market cap, price, it's going to be a good start. If you want to change the price, which I like to look at stock over 20 cent. I know it's a low number, but sometimes there's like some really cheap stock in play. If it's there, I just want to see it. But most of the time, this scan is going to just take off all of these example or all of these stock, because they're not going to fit the other criteria. But if it does, I don't want to be restricted by price or not see the stock because of price. Market cap, I'm going to put something around the 20 million. I don't want to see something that's really, really low. So 20 million is going to be fine. After that, performances, this is going to be depending on what we're looking for. So we said a 6 month for this scanner. So I want to look for 6 months stock that move at least 20%. It's going to be pretty important, because you want to get rid of the stock that are just not really moving. And then volume on the day, I can go manual and put 1 million. And I know he uses dollar volume, but I personally use to prefer share, because I don't like to trade stock that are not trading enough share, because when you're holding them overnight, it's just really weird to not have any prints or no way to get out. So at least 1 million volume is going to be good enough to have a bit more momentum in a stock, or more, I mean, better flow of trading it. So volatility, I like to go over 3% and above. If you're someone that really looks for more of the small cap momentum, look at something like 5 or 7%. It's going to be more accurate. But if you like these bigger company, I think 3% is going to be good enough. So now what we're going to do is we're going to change these stuff over here. So change percent, it's fine. Volume, it's good. Relative volume, market cap is also good. PE, remove this, because sometimes it doesn't really matter if the stock has momentum. This one, we're going to remove it. And after that, this one also, and this one also. So next thing you're going to do here is performance. You're going to click on it. And then what you're going to do is look for the 6 month performance. Then you're going to move it right over here, and you're going to be able to sort it by descending. So which one has moved the most? Then after, you're gonna go into revenue growth. So revenue growth percent, and you can go trailing month year over year. I think it's a pretty good way to see if the company generates money, or I can go into revenue and revenue growth and then look at quarterly year over year. So the same quarter the next year, because if you look at quarterly after quarter, so quarter to quarter, it might be different because sometime, example, you look at Apple, they're gonna make more money when it's gonna be the holidays because they sell more iPhone, and example. So you have to compare the year over year, but by quarter, to see if there's actual growth in them. So quarterly, year over year, that's good for me. Then I'll move it here and I'll move it here and I'll leave sector because you wanna see sometime if there's a team, right? If anything is in the financial or electronic and technology, you wanna know about that stuff. So this is what we have right now for this list. And you can see over here that maybe a 20 cent range or 20 cent minimum price range is not good enough. So we'll put it at $1 to have a cleaner feed. And then we'll put market cap example at 100 or 1 billion. So we can see more like the larger cap stock. And then performance 6 months, 20% volume, volatility, and we can save it. Normally I would save it in my 6 month scan, but it's already there, so I won't do that, but just save it. And it's gonna ask you over here to rename it. So when it's done, now what you're gonna have is you can sort it by descending, ascending, or volume, and you're gonna have your price, change percent, volume, relative volume, market cap, and all of the important data that you need. And what I like to do is double check with what I already have to make sure it's accurate. So when we compare it, this is my 1 month scan. I can go to my 6 month scan. And what I have over here is almost the same thing, except for mine, I don't have the market cap. So I can remove the market cap just to, you know, show the difference. Performance 6 month, I have 10%. Sometimes I like to scan a bit wider, so you can adjust it to 10%. And next thing you know, what I do is literally just sort by descending so I can see the top movers, and you can choose the name that you want because I do already have the scan. I won't rename it the same thing. So I'll do RRR, you know, when we create these good name to save these things. So I already have it. I'll save it like this. So now it's there. It's showing on the custom view because you can have overview, but I like to have the custom view, which is going to be this one. And then what you're going to do is you're going to go into control A, it's going to select all of them. And then you're going to do add to watch list, and you're going to create a watch list, which is going to be the 6 month. So I'll do 6M. It's going to be like this. And now you can see you're going to have a watch list that you can scroll through very quickly. And the way I do that is normally I just open a chart like this over here, and then what I have is I'll go to the 6M, which is going to be this one. And then I can just really scroll through that list and just see every ticker that are important to me or that are going to be maybe breaking out or breaking down, depending on the setup that I'm looking for. And you know, when you like something and you think it could break out if it reaches a level, let's say this stock over here, which I don't know what it is, but in case, I'll set an alert somewhere in that level. And what I do for the alert is gonna work also on the regular trading hour, but I like to put it on the hourly so it actually works for the extended trading hour. So you can go over here and add alert. So it's gonna work on the extended trading hours. So this is the price that it's gonna be working at, and it's gonna work for extended and not just regular. When you're using TC2000, which is really annoying, is that your alert don't go in the pre and post market. They only work during regular trading hours, which is really annoying because at the open, everything that moves above a certain alert that you had is gonna start beeping and you don't know really what's going on, or you couldn't really prepare for it. Versus here, it's gonna alert you maybe at 7 a.m. whenever it crosses that because there was some news or something like that. So it's gonna be easier. So same thing over here, you can just create alert, add, and I like to put only once and then open ended so it doesn't have to be in the next week or something like that. And during the day, what's going to happen, it's over here. So all your alerts are going to be logged right over here. And I did also remove the active one that I have. I just want to see the one that are actually going off. If I want to remove some, then I go over here and remove them. But most likely, it's just going to be over here and it's going to beep. And then all of a sudden I'll see a message here that the alarm actually went off. So when it comes to the other scan that you can have, I normally look for the 1 month, the 3 month, and the 6 months. So the only thing you're gonna need to change is really the performance. And then you're gonna go into, instead of 6 months, you're gonna go 3 months, and then you're gonna save it. But the one I really like to look at for stuff that are like really, really in play or multi-day stock, I like to look at the 1 week, and then I'll look at 10%, which is fine. I'll look at stuff with more volume. For example, it's gonna be 5 million at least. And then I'll go volatility, I'll go over 5 and above. And then price, this is the one I'll really go about over 20 cent. And this one, I won't really care about the revenue growth or anything like that. What I'm looking for is really small cap momentum, multi-day runner. And then I'll do the same thing. I'll just save this one for small cap using this save button, or just rename. You can put it as small cap. And then I'll do change something over here, which is I'll remove this. I'll go into performance. And then I'll go look at the 1 week. And I'll move this over here. And then what I'll do also is really, you know, put it descending. So what's the most up on the week? And then I'll do the same thing. So I normally use this scanner at night, not really during the day. So then you can also add, and then you can create new lists and just put weekly. So I won't put the exact name because it's going to copy to the watch list I have. So I'll put on this one, and then I'll be able to do the same thing as just scroll. So what I do normally is just have to move this somewhere, and then I'll bring back this chart over here, which is going to be my scanner. And then I'll look at this one, and then I can say, okay, this is something that's like really in play. I'll look on the 15 minute, and then I'll scan through everything that I can see or that I think is interesting. And I'll just set some alert for everything that's really running through the week. It's like, you know, something like this. I don't know what it is. I'll do a bit more research, and then I'll set my alert. This is not really in play, but you know, you can set an alert if we come back to this high. Reddit is in play at the moment. There's CLSK that was somewhere around this range. So you could have an alert around the 2120. Like all of these stuff that are like really moving are normally going to be in the 1 week or 1 month. So to find out or find these setup, I really like to use the 1 week. And then after that, you can do the same thing over here and just change it to manual setup and go over here for the 1 month. And then you're going to have pretty much all of the stuff. A lot of similar names, but sometimes more names, stuff that are a bit slower. But this is how you would find out all of these setup. So thanks for watching this video. If you enjoyed, like and subscribe. Also, let me know if you need more details about this scanner or go into more scanner that I currently have. So thanks again. Peace.